I first heard that Philips Hue were going to make a HDMI sync box to sync your lights to your TV picture, I thought to myself, please don't Philips this up.
Hey Eric, I've done it!
I don't know what accent this is, just go with it.
I've created the first Philips Hue microchip to allow synchronization with a TV's picture. How much should I charge for it?
Carry the three...
A gajillion pounds!
They Philipsed it harder than they've ever Philipsed anything ever. But what if I told you this could be achieved for 1/7 of the price? A 1/7 of the price. Times less expensive. I've written here in my notes to raise my eyebrows to demonstrate the enormity of the situation. Massive thanks to Govee for sponsoring today's video and sending me their Flow Pro light bar system. This thing is preposterously good value for money, and it's their second stab at Philips Hue's HDMI sync box. Their first stab was this LED strip-based product that you can see me very professionally attaching to my father-in-law's TV in this footage here. And when I reviewed it about a year ago, I felt that it was really good, but sometimes the colors could be a little bit off. This new system is far more accurate and has less latency. The light bars themselves are actually really well made and incredibly bright for their ridiculously low price tag. The colour reproduction is... What? What are you looking at?
It's got a camera system on it! It's using a bloody it's comparing a camera system to Philips Hue! Philips Hue doesn't need a camera system!
You're right. Philips Hue doesn't need a camera. It needs another 340 flipping pounds because that's how much more money it costs. So yes, this system does rely on a camera to monitor the screen in order to decide what color to make the lights. But for the first time ever, you can now decide whether to mount the camera on the top of your screen or on the bottom of your screen. And although I'd prefer not to have a camera at all, there are actually some advantages to this method over and above having a HDMI box. First of all, the Govee setup will never become obsolete because it just mimics the colours of whatever you point the camera at. I could point it at the picture from my Fire TV stick. I could point it at the picture from my Sky TV. I can point it at the picture from my Xbox. I could even point it at this photo of Philips Hue's CEO. It won't matter if I upgrade my TV, or if HDMI standards change, or if frame rates increase over the years, whereas Philips Hue's sync box is already obsolete. The Hue sync box can currently only handle 60 frames per second. As soon as you increase it to 120 frames per second, it sh**s its pants. I wonder why that could be. I wonder, why would that, could it be? It couldn't possibly. Is it? Planned obsolescence, because making money through innovation is just too hard. 120 frames per second was already a thing when Philips Hue released the sync box. In 2 or 3 years' time, you'll be potting out another £230 to buy the next Philips Hue sync box so that it'll work with your shiny new console. Why?
Corporate greed!
The light bars can be installed in the stands that come with it, which work really well, or you can install them into these sticky mounts that also come with it, or you can just dangle them precariously from the mess that you pretend doesn't exist behind your monitors. If Josh from Tech Tesseract is watching this video, he's going to be like,
"Hello darkness, my old friend."
It took ages to draw on Josh's beard. Is this a good look for me? The camera and the light bars both attach to this very basic central console, which provides them with power and allows you to make very simple adjustments to the lights. And to get more finite adjustments to the lights, it's simply a case of installing the Govee app from the Play Store or from the iOS Store, so that you can then do things like add it to She That Should Not Be Named or Google Assistant, or do things like set scenes. Within 15 minutes, I'd got the physical installation of the product completed, I'd got the app to synchronize to the lights, and I'd managed to get She That Should Not Be Named to control it with my voice.
Alexa,
illuminate the train wreck.
Illuminating the train wreck now. Josh isn't mad, he's just disappointed.
The app has several main functions, and the first of which is music mode. You've probably seen this sort of thing before on other devices. It's where a small microphone exists in the housing of the product, and it's listening to the music to then decide what to do with the lights. Most channels on YouTube would probably use some funky music and a sexy montage to demonstrate this. Not me.
Hello, Clarice. Hello, Clarice. Hello, Clarice.
It's not enough for you. You want a sexy Tech Tesseract-inspired musical montage? Tough.
The other modes are video mode, which makes the lights follow your TV screen, color mode, which allows you to simply select a solid color, scene mode, which includes things like candlelight flicker and rainbow effects, and finally DIY mode, where you can select your own colors and create your own animations. The lights themselves are also RGBIC. This means that it's got more than one LED in each bar, so that you can do things like rainbow effects. And this is something you don't get with a Philips Hue Play Bar, for example. The thing that's a bit of a shame is that it's heavily underutilized. The only times that I've found this thing uses RGBIC is when you set the rainbow effect, or in one of the music modes. And neither one uses a smooth transition. It's kind of this weird, jerky transition. I'm hoping that Govee will be doing some kind of firmware update at some point to expand the use of RGBIC so that I can do things like just have a smooth transition of a rainbow effect on my wall. There's nothing really wrong with these lights, especially considering that they're under £50, but there are some things that could be improved. The first one is that both lights just light up the same color in video mode. I would have expected that the left-hand side of the screen would be monitored and it would produce a color for that side, and the right-hand side would be monitored and it would produce a separate color for that side. That doesn't seem to be the case. I was surprised at how little this actually mattered to me. I think if you watched the demo at the beginning of this video and you didn't notice either, well then welcome to my world. I didn't notice until I started filming them facing me for this video and suddenly thought, hang on a minute, they're the same color all of the time. You could argue that having different colors all over the place is actually more of a distraction, and that by monitoring the screen and picking the average color and producing it all the way around is probably less of a distraction. Everyone in the comments can now scream at me, "My Philips Hue Sync Box made lights go everywhere! It's so much better! Oh my god!" I don't care. The only other negative point I've not already made really is that the voice control is a little bit more limited than I would like. You can turn it on and off, you can set certain scenes, but you can't change it to video mode, which is kind of important. I want to be able to switch it between solid color when I'm chilling out or doing whatever, but video mode when I'm watching a movie or a TV show or playing a game. That isn't an option using my mouth hole, and therefore I have to get the app out of my pocket. I am seriously nitpicking though, this thing costs less than £50, and they're really, really nice lights. They're pretty to look at, they work with Google Home and She That Should Not Be Named, and as an added bonus if you want to do the whole camera thing, you've got that too, and it does it really well. If you're looking for an alternative to the Philips Hue HDMI sync box, which is going to cost 1/7 of the price, there are links in the description to where you can pick these up. I hope you've enjoyed today's video. If you have, please give it a thumbs up. That'll tell YouTube's algorithms it was a good video and more people should see it. If you want to see some more of this guy, hit that subscribe button and ding that bell. If you ding the bell, it lets YouTube know you want to be notified when I upload videos. These are my favorite people in the world. They're my patrons from Patreon. Without those guys, there would be no channel. I would not still be doing this. They keep me going. If you want to be one of these amazing people, you can do that at either Patreon or buy me a one-off beer at PayPal. And either way, I'll flipping well love you forever. These are my Facebooks and my Twitters and my Instagrams. Come and hang out there and we can be best friends. See you next time. How much shall be charged for it? I don't know what accent that is. A gajillion pounds! This means that it's got more than one LED in each bar so that it can do things like rainbow effects. My wig almost flew off. That's how angry he is. He's so angry, his wig almost fell off.